We continued on to Semuc Champey. It's a really nice twisty mountain ride once you get closer to Lanquin.
Green mountains.
Green, beautiful mountains.
We stopped at a hostel in Lanquin. It was really, really scenic. The Lanquin River runs right through the hostel's property. But we did see a sign near the parking lot that said, "Attention, armed vigilante, caution."
The hostel also had a sign that was stressing the fact that it was 100% Guatemalan owned and operated. Apparently, the local hostels are at odds because some of them are foreign owned. People come in and buy properties, start hostels. Other travelers work there for free for room and board, and it doesn't really help the local people or the economies. So if you want to actually get the inside scoop on what it's like to live there and practice your Spanish, try to hunt down places that are locally owned and run.
The next morning, the sky opened up and rain poured down on us, turning all the nearby roads into mud. It rained consistently for most of the day, so we waited for things to dry up before riding towards Semuc Champey. We heard the road was particularly challenging, and we thought it was best to ride when it's a little bit drier. Amy rode on the back of Becky's bike, and we headed into Lanquin to get some breakfast. There we met a few travelers from New Zealand named Ash and Yako. They had actually had some extra space in their van, so we stuck Amy in there.
People had told us the road in was really bad. They said just a couple weeks ago, two guys had come in on dual sport bikes and had to send their broken bikes out on a truck. So we were a little concerned that carrying a passenger might be a bit much for us. The road forks, and on the left there's a bridge that you need to go across to head to Semuc, and people were jumping off into the water right as we were passing the bridge.
We met Amy and Ash and Yako in the parking lot and headed toward the entrance. Hot from the ride, we quickly stashed our clothes and jumped in the water. We watched a bunch of people jumping in from along the cliffs, so we had to climb up and jump in too.
He also did what Yako calls rock running. He found a rock with a large string attached to it. It's really fun, actually. You grab this rock, and then you can see to the bottom, and you can run across the pools. So you got, like, a full experience of the pools. Back at the hostel, we had noticed a little VW bus that had parked down, and people were camping out of the back of it, and we went and introduced ourselves. Their names are Ben and Sean, and it turns out that they're doing a video blog, too. They've been video blogging since Chile, where they bought their little bus, and they'd been driving it north to Alaska with their dog named Alaska. So if you want another awesome adventure to follow, you should check out their video blogs. You can look up Asa Alaska on YouTube. They're super cool, super nice people, and it was a lot of fun to talk to them about making video blogs.
We went back to Semuc Champey with Ben and Sean and their really adorable dog. This time we opted to take a 4x4 colectivo, or a truck. We all piled in with a bunch of locals. The road was extremely bumpy.
Alaska hiked up to the Mirador with us. She's a really adorable hiker. And we had a great view of the pools. I definitely recommend going to the Mirador first, preferably, because you're so hot after that steep hike that the pools feel incredible. We ate some awesome chicken afterward.
Mmm, delicious, delicious chicken.
We caught the last truck back to the hostel, and the next morning said some heartfelt goodbyes to Ben and Sean. They're really fun, and we all really wish that we were traveling in the same direction so we could travel together, but alas, they're coming from South America, and we're going to it. Were you staring off weird in that one when I said that?
A lot of them.